This video is about the prevention of COVID-19 infections. The need to take preventative procedures against COVID-19 infections is critically important because of the deadly nature of the disease. There are many preventative measures currently recommended by the World Health Organization, WHO, for the world, and the Center for Diseases Control, CDC, in the United States. These are some of the common recommended preventative measures. 1. Wearing of masks. 2. Hand washing. 3. Using a hand sanitizer. 4. Quarantine. 5. Social distancing and staying home. 1. Wearing a mask. Mask is a covering, which you wear around your nose and mouth, as a measure of protection from the environment. Over the last year, we have heard the importance of masks, illustrated to us, over and over, through multiple platforms, including the TV channels, social media, and health publications. The current recommendation for protective facial covering involves a type of mask that is multiple layered and non-valved, in order to really reduce the spread of the COVID-19 virus through aerosols from the mouth. This protective covering is particularly valuable when worn around infected persons who are asymptomatic, as reports have shown them to be responsible for more than 50% of SARS-CoV-2 transmissions. Hence, it is important to note that wearing a mask is not just for self-protection, but also for the protection of the community as a whole. Types of masks. Cloth mask without filter. The most common types of masks worn these days, and are also popularly becoming fashion statements, are the cloth masks without a filter. These are particularly popular, not just because of the different patterns and colors these are available in, but also because they can be easily made at home. Their ability to protect one from the virus further depends on the number of layers of cotton used to make these masks. It has been seen that while a single layered cotton mask may be able to block out 1% of particles, a two layers cotton mask is much more effective, as seen by its 35% particle filtration. Overall, these cotton masks are a good option to decrease the spread of the virus, due to their ability to reduce transmission of droplets emitted from the mouth by a distance of 8 feet to 2.5 inches. Cloth masks with filter. While the cloth masks without a filter are usually made at home, the ones with a filter have an additional layer of filter which enhances the blocking effect of the mask, and is usually purchased from a store. The recommended filter material used in these masks is a polypropylene sheet, which is a fabric made up of synthetic fibers. By adding the polypropylene filter to a two-layered cotton mask, you may be able to filter out up to 70% of the particles, making it much more efficient in performing its protective role. Surgical mask. Surgical masks are the most common types of masks used in a hospital or clinical setting, and were widely used even before the onset of the corona pandemic. These are usually blue or green in color, and made up of a thin paper-like material, which is usually 1 to 2 layers thick. However, their fragility must not be confused with their inability to control the transmission, as these thick masks are particularly created for blocking the transmission of small droplets, and may be able to filter out 60% of small particles. Hence, they are advised to be worn in outdoor and public settings to protect yourself and others from spreading the disease. N95 respirator masks. The gold standard when it comes to masks protecting against COVID-19 is the N95 respirator. What makes it at the top of the leaderboard is its ability to filter out 95% of the particles in the air, which is much higher than any other mask mentioned above. or commonly available in the market. Its very high efficiency makes it particularly short in the market, and is usually reserved for the health professionals, especially those who are serving in the COVID wards. How effective are masks at stopping the spread of COVID-19? Masks are amongst the most important personal protective equipment, which helps to protect us against virus-containing aerosols and droplets. To further study the efficacy of masks worn in an outdoor setting, a review was conducted, including 21 previous studies done on the subject matter. The results of the studies showed that whenever a mask was worn by a healthcare or a non-healthcare worker, the respiratory droplets emitted were blocked by 80% and 47% respectively. The review concluded, by proving masks as an effective method of stopping the transmission of the virus. 2. Hand washing. Hand washing is one of the most important steps in helping to control the spread of the virus. Every time someone washed their hands with any kind of soap and running water, they are able to remove the majority of dirt and germs collected on their hands, which in turn reduce their chances of getting infected with the virus. When to wash hands. Frequent washing of your hands has become a must, especially in the times that we are living in today. You must try to wash your hands as regularly as you can, especially after performing an activity where you are required to touch potentially infectious or dirty objects. You must also try to wash your hands before and after eating food, going to the bathroom, touching a dirty diaper, blowing or touching our nose, touching the dustbin, taking out the trash, or after being in a close encounter with an ill person. However, taking into consideration the rapid spread of the SARS-CoV-2 virus worldwide, you must take extra precautions and try to wash your hands before touching sensitive parts of your body, like the eyes or nose. You must also make sure to wash your hands after coming home from the outdoors or touching an object that may be touched by many before you, like a door handle or an elevator button. How to wash hands. The proper way to wash your hands requires 5 basic steps. These include: first, wet your hands under a running water source. The water may be hot or cold. Then apply soap to your hands and rub in the soap enough to lather it up. Be sure to include the back of your hands in between your fingers and inside the nails. Rub the soap into your hands for at least 20 seconds. Rinse your soap off your hands under running water. You may dry them with a clean cloth or by air dry. How can hand washing prevent COVID-19 transmission? It has been seen that there are different attitudes towards hand washing for different cultures around the world. Some cultures promote it more than the others, and hence, it was easier for them to abide by the new guidelines prescribed by the public health organizations regarding COVID-19 around the world. This difference in hand washing attitude all around the world was investigated in a study, and it was found that the differences in the spread of the COVID-19 infection all around the world may be partly because of the differences in hand washing habits. Hence, the areas where hand washing is not practiced as frequently as the others, the COVID-19 count is much higher, and vice versa. This shows the importance of hand washing and just how big of a part it plays in the control of the viral pandemic. 3. Using a hand sanitizer. Although washing your hands under running water with soap is considered the best way to clean your hands before and after an activity, you may also use a sanitizer. If you are somewhere where you don't have access to water or soap, the most frequently used hand sanitizer is one that contains at least 60% alcohol. Because that is the threshold level needed to kill off germs. While also not harming your skin in doing so. How to use a hand sanitizer? Using a hand sanitizer is quite simple. However, for someone who has not used it before, these are the correct steps one should follow while using a sanitizer to access its maximum potential. Firstly, make sure your hands are clean from all kinds of visible particles, like grease, food, or dirt. Make sure all organic matter is removed from hands. You may do this by either washing your hands or just using a napkin or tissue. Next, take out a small amount of sanitizer onto the palm of your clean hand. The sanitizer may be about the size of a dime. Then, rub both of your hands until the sanitizer has spread evenly to all parts. Focus particularly on your fingers and the outer surfaces of the palm. The benefits of using a hand sanitizer. Using a hand sanitizer has numerous benefits, which is why it has been recommended as a part of the preventive protocols for COVID-19 by almost all the countries. You can also judge its popularity by the currently empty shelves that were once filled with sanitizers in the past in supermarkets and stores. These benefits include time-efficient method of cleaning of hands, especially when you are traveling or in a hurry. The alcohol in the sanitizer that acts quickly by killing off the microorganism after initial contact can be taken with you anywhere you go. Unlike a sink, sanitizers are required in small amounts, so may not irritate your skin as much. Hand sanitizer versus soap and water. Washing your hands with soap and water is considered superior to using a hand sanitizer due to its ability to act as a one-step way to completely rid of all organic and inorganic particulate matter. Meanwhile, using a sanitizer requires you to clean your hands before use. However, this does not mean that using a hand sanitizer does not have its own importance. It is equally important, especially in the cases of traveling or being somewhere where you don't have access to water. Moreover, hand sanitizers can also be used after washing your hands as an additional safety precaution against the coronavirus. 4. Quarantine. Quarantine is a term which is often confused with isolation, which is very different, especially when the current pandemic is kept under consideration. While isolation is the complete separation of an infected person from their family, friends, and society in general, until they are completely recovered, quarantine is a less severe form of isolation, where those are at risk of exposure to the virus are advised to separate and restrict their outdoor movements. Sometimes, the individuals who are required to quarantine themselves are not infected, but it is their possible exposure that requires them to separate themselves for a particular number of days. WHO is required to quarantine. The number of days a person may be required to quarantine may differ slightly between different countries. However, an ideal and highly accepted quarantine for coronavirus is 14 days. The types of people who are generally required to undergo quarantine for a specific number of days include some who have a family member or a close friend being recently diagnosed with COVID-19, a group of individuals who were in close proximity to an infected person. This may include individuals in a workplace setting who shared a room or office, or even healthcare professionals who came in contact with some infected patient. A group of people on a larger scale may be required to quarantine after flying to a new place or before an important social event. the residents of a state or area where COVID spread is particularly high, and it is advised by the local public health officials to undergo a period of quarantine due to the risk of each resident being exposed to the virus. Types of quarantine. 1. Home quarantine. Home quarantine is ideal for those who have adequate space at home to not only allow them to not leave their house, but to also maintain social distancing within its boundaries. Work quarantine. Work quarantine may be available for those individuals who may have been exposed to an infected person, but at the same time are required to continue working. This is why they may be allowed to quarantine together at either a particular facility allotted to them or some other place with proper infection control protocols followed. Social quarantine. Social quarantine is when public events, big meetings, or places of mass accumulation, like schools, are closed to allow less interaction of the members of the society with each other. This lack of physical interaction will, in turn, prevent the transmission of the disease and help flatten the curve for COVID spread in that area. This social quarantine is usually implemented by the leader of a state, keeping in mind the rate of spread of the virus in the area, how well their economy is doing, and also the resources they currently have. How effective is quarantine at stopping the spread of COVID? To further study just how efficient quarantining is at stopping the spread of coronavirus, a number of studies have been conducted since the start of the pandemic. A recent review included all of these studies and investigated the overall effect of quarantine on COVID-19 spread, along with the COVID-19 virus, which is also known as the SARS-CoV-2. The review also included studies conducted on other SARS diseases, along with the Middle Eastern Respiratory Syndrome, which is also known as MERS. This is because COVID-19 is a fairly new disease, and there were not many numbers and enough time to come to a conclusive decision. The 51 studies that were included in the review were evaluated for the number of SARS and MERS cases, the rate at which the viral infections spread amongst the community, the number of deaths that resulted from the virus, and how much it cost for the people to quarantine. The studies that focused particularly on COVID-19 showed that those who quarantined had far fewer numbers of people infected with the infection, along with a reduction in the total number of deaths. Hence, quarantine resulted in at least 44% reduction of the spread of the SARS-CoV-2 virus, and a maximum of 96%. Just like the reduction of the infection rate, the death rate also significantly decreased by at least 31%, and a maximum of 76%. The review concluded by suggesting that the practice of quarantine, along with other social distancing measures, may prove to be very effective for controlling the spread of the COVID-19 virus. 5. Social distancing and staying home. Social distancing is an act of physically distancing oneself, others in the society. In simple words, it is just the act of keeping physical space between yourselves and other people who do not live in your house. The current protocol for social distancing is that one must try to keep a solid 6 feet distance between themselves and another person while communicating outdoors. The best way that social distancing can be practiced is to not leave the house in the first place for unnecessary things. Social distancing and staying home are amongst the most common precautions introduced by the government, and following them as an essential way to control the spread of COVID-19. Why is social distancing important? COVID is a viral infection that makes it highly infectious and can be transmitted to hundreds of people in a matter of minutes. The spread of SARS-CoV-2, which is the virus responsible for COVID-19 infection, mainly spreads through air droplets from an infected person, aerosols from an infected person, and respiratory secretions from an infected person. This means, every time a person who is infected with the virus coughs, sneezes, or even talks, they may emit the virus in the form of aerosols from their mouth, which may be inhaled by a healthy person. Moreover, the chances of inhalation of these aerosols increase significantly if a number of people are in close proximity to each other. Hence, it is recommended by the health authorities all over the world to try to maintain a distance of at least 6 feet or 2 meters, which may not only protect you, but the other person as well. Some people may question, why do we have to maintain social distance from every person? If a person is infected, they will automatically show symptoms. And that is when there is a need to maintain our distance. However, this argument is completely wrong. Since according to recent studies, a big number of people may be infected with the virus without showing symptoms initially. And it is a general rule to consider every person as infected. Can social distancing and staying home prevent the spread of COVID? As mentioned above, the most common mode of transmission of SARS-CoV-2 is through droplets, which may be transmitted into the air by an infected person via sneezing, coughing, talking, or singing. Hence, an area with increased population density may have higher droplet transmission due to the close proximity of the people. In a recent study, the effect of social distancing was seen on the reproduction number of the virus. Reproduction number, or R value, is generally used for viruses to see just how many more individuals one infected individual may infect. So a pathogen with a higher R number will be able to infect much more of the population than one which has a low R value. The basic reference value that is often taken for the R number is 1. Hence, if a pathogen has an R value of greater than 1, it would mean that one infected person will infect more than one individual with successively increasing numbers. While a value is less than 1 would suggest that the transmission of the virus will eventually stop. The study was based in the US and included at least 211 counties, whose selection was based on the population size and the number of infected individuals. The criteria were that the county should have at least one case of the virus after February 2020. And the population size should be at least 100,000. The daily changes in the number of COVID cases were taken from the New York Times daily updates. While the measure of social distancing amongst individuals of the county was noted by the daily cell phone movements, this cellular data allowed insight into the people's movements, the distance they traveled, and the percentage of visitors to unimportant places, like restaurants and salons within the county. These movements and visitations were then compared to the previous movements between the period of February and March, which was taken as the baseline time. It was seen that by the middle of April 2020, the visits to non-essential business places had reduced by almost 69%. It was also seen that the reduction in the rate of transmission of virus, or the R value, had also decreased by 54% in those places that have 50% fewer visitations. Tips for social distancing when going out. The governments of every country around the world have announced strict social distancing laws in order to control the new rise in cases of COVID-19. Here are some of the ways you can practice social distancing. Before going out, you must plan your visit according to the guidelines prescribed by your law enforcers and the local health authorities. While traveling, you must ideally try to prevent using densely filled public transports, like buses and trains. Instead, if you can, try walking, bicycling, rolling, skating, and driving down to your workplace or another everyday commute. However, if that is not an option for you, try your best to maintain at least 6 feet or 2 meter distance between you and other passengers on the bus or train that you take. You can also follow this at the bus stops and train stations as you wait for your transport to come. If you are booking a taxi or online ride services, try to prevent the one which allows pooling, and also try to sit at the back seat to be able to maintain a safe distance from the driver. Try to get out of your house only when you absolutely need to. Try not to go to the stores, restaurants, or hair salons for minor reasons. Moreover, instead of going to the marketplace to get your grocery every few days, try to buy for the whole month at once. You don't have to go again and again. When at the stores, try to keep a safe distance of at least 6 feet or 2 meters between you and the other customers. Stay safe. Here is the end of this video on COVID-19 prevention. Don't forget to check out the other COVID-19 videos on this channel. If you found it valuable, like, comment, share, and subscribe to receive alerts when we produce these types of videos in the future. Subscription to our YouTube channel is totally free. Thanks for watching. Note: this information is for education and reference only. It is not meant to replace the informed advice of your doctor. If you believe that you have a health problem, please consult your doctor or health care provider. Do not resort to self-help. We hope you enjoyed this video. See you again soon.